It is so unbelievably hot. How are you guys? I hope everyone is doing great. I hope you guys are staying safe. It has been a while. I am so sorry for taking such a long break. I was not well. I was just not well. But I'm back. I'm better. And I have a lot to say about Bigg Boss OTT that is currently streaming on Voot. First off, I am just so happy to be back in my element. Here's a little backstory. I was actually approached to be a part of the auditioning process. They told me the entire concept beforehand, and earlier it was supposed to be 3 months with Voot and then 3 months on Colors. And when they told me the entire thing, it just did not sound too right to me, because I personally just did not want to spend 6 months doing the same thing, especially on TV. So it was just not the opportunity that I was looking for. Of course, I am a huge Bigg Boss fan. I am a Salman Khan fan. Bigg Boss would have been great for me, but since it was on Voot and it just needed a lot of commitment, I could not do it, which is why I had to let it go. But I thought it's really interesting that I already knew the entire format and everything about it before it was aired. That's a cool little story for you guys. Now coming to the actual show, this show is a little weirder than what I expected. So the host is Karan Johar. Unpopular opinion, I actually like Karan Johar. I mean, he makes pretty entertaining movies and I like his personality and it's all chill. I don't have a problem with him, but the entire show has this very weird tone. There are very weird jokes going on between the show host and the contestants, and it gives me the icks, you know. I am guessing that almost everyone watches Bigg Boss with their families, because we just have nothing to do at 9 PM. Bigg Boss OTT is something that you will be very uncomfortable watching because of the underlying jokes and stuff. So the introductory episode, it was 3.5 hours long and I watched the entire thing. First off, the editors could have done a better job. They could have easily made it into like a 1 hour, 1 hour 30 minute episode, but they decided not to. I remember a video that we did on celebrity street style. Most hated celebrity that we think has a pretty good sense of style is
Karan Johar.
इससे पहले कोई भी बोले नेपोटिज्म,
नेपोटिज्म का कपड़ों से कोई लेना नहीं, ठीक है, ये कपड़ों से पिक्चर नहीं बन रहा, वो कपड़े अच्छे पहनते हैं.
And he decides to wear this. Why did you have to prove me wrong in front of so many people? It is single-handedly the most hideous thing I think anyone has ever worn on television. I was just rethinking my entire video that day. Let's start talking about the contestants. Okay, so I don't have a list of all the contestants. So I'm going to refer to this article done by Times of India. Alright, so the first mentioned contestant is Shamita Shetty. I mean, I have made some really bad decisions in my life, some really questionable decisions in my life, but nothing compares to this one. Did no one tell Shamita that this is actually a really bad time to go on show like Bigg Boss? Celebrities are so out of touch that it's so weird to me that they don't understand what is actually going on around them and how people are actually perceiving them. I personally think Shamita should not have been like a part of this show, at least this year. I mean, your brother-in-law is still in jail for doing something very I'm pretty sure everyone knows about it. When I saw Shamita, the only thing that I could think of was she's gonna get into a fight one day and someone is going to ask her for links, man. Like, it is going to happen. It is going to happen. It has to happen. If I was in the house, I would have done it. I mean, but other than that, I think Shamita has a really nice personality. She is very soft-spoken, a little snobby, but still meh. The next contestant is Divya Agarwal. The only reason that I know of her name is because she caused a huge scene in the last season. I think it was the last season. So apparently Divya and Priyank used to date, but they broke up before Priyank entered the Bigg Boss house, but Divya was not too happy about it and she decided to create a huge scene, like a huge huge scene on national television. I don't think anyone in their right mind would have done that. She calls it a meltdown, but I would call it being hungry for attention. I don't really like her. I have never really liked her ever since I saw her on Big Boss trying to slander Priyank's name, but that's just my personal choice. Apart from that, she looked really, really nice. She looked stunning, but of course her entire personality is a little annoying. I mean, I shouldn't be the one talking about high pitches and annoying voices because I have very weird pitch and I have a very annoying voice, but I'm going to say it because I can. She has a very, very annoying voice. Also, when Divya was on stage, I got to know that she was a backup dancer for Student of the Year, so she has already worked with Karan Johar before, which actually invalidates a lot of her arguments that she makes on later in the show, because she instantly gets into a lot of fights which are not actually initiated by her but by a co-contestant that we will talk about later, because I'm saving him for the last. The third contestant is Rakesh Bapat. He is a very, very well-known face. I knew that I have seen him in serials, even though no one at my house actually watches serials, but he's a very popular face. He's a very well-known face and he looks really, really decent and soft-spoken. He looks very, I want to be in a pottery class in London, but I do not have the budget for it, so I'm just gonna stick with Big Boss. I have absolutely no idea what a soft-spoken, decent, well-mannered, well-known face like him is doing in Big Boss, but I guess good for him. He actually looks pretty boring, so I don't know what he's gonna do to the show, but let's just wait and see. The next contestant is Neha Bhasin. Fun fact, I have been a huge fan of her music. I love her music, but I did not know what she looked like. She looks very strong, you know, the rebel kind, but she is like a little old to be a rebel. I don't know if I should say that, but she has this entire girl boss vibe that I personally think it's a little overdone in Indian TV shows. I would know because I have a lot of tattoos and people perceive me in a very, very different way. But that is the thing with Indian television. They try to push an image of people according to what they look like. Anyway, Neha Bhasin is a huge personality. She has done so well in her career. I don't know why she's a part of this show. I just hope this show does not do more damage than good to her career, because I actually really like her music. The next contestant is Zeeshan Khan. I did not know who he was up until he introduced himself, and apparently he's a YouTube star. I don't know if I'm allowed to say this, but he is like Danish Zehn and Ranveer Singh in like a little bottle mixed up. He just has this very fake persona. I hate people who have a fake personality. The moment that he started talking, I knew it ki ye real life mein aise baat nahi karta hai, but ye stage pe aake jaan ke aise baat karke dikha raha hai. But I don't understand, like, how do people not have good friends? Main agar kabhi aise baat karti to sabse pehle mujh pe mere friends haste ki what the fuck are you doing. Apparently that is very cool to him and his viewers, but he looked like a really nice guy. He actually looked very sweet, like, as a person, but he does not like wearing clothes. Like, bro, why are you not wearing clothes? Wo pura time nanga hi rehta hai. Wo pura time nanga rehta hai. The next contestant is Ridhima Pandit. I love her. I love her face. I love her energy. So pretty. I don't remember maine usko last time kahan dekha tha, but I'm pretty sure it was on some dance reality show. I think. I'm not too sure about anything in life. I think she's too nice to be in this show. If she ever goes to nomination, I am voting for her. Milind Gaba. Another backstory, guys. Milind Gaba is actually my school friend's cousin. I was in the same class. We were best friends in school. We lost touch, of course. I am not very good at staying in touch. But they are cousins, and I knew about Milind ever since I was like a little kid, and he used to make music like for himself. I really admire his entire career, this entire journey. Of course, he has that West Delhi energy, and this is not in an offensive way. I am also from West Delhi, so I know. It was really nice seeing him on the show. I mean, the entire show was getting filled up with either like really young people or like super old television artists. So it was really nice to see someone with a little bit of personality standing like the middle ground. So in conclusion, I actually really like Milind Kabra. Next is Karan Nath. Again, I did not know who he was until he introduced himself. And he actually has a really sad story. He had a movie that came out about 14 years ago. And then after that, he was looking for work, but he apparently did not get any. I don't know. His entire introduction was really, really sad. But I'm happy that he got a platform to prove himself. I just hope he gets some good work because he looks like a really, really decent guy. He has this very weird expression all the time, but that's fine. The next contestant is Urfi Javed. She is so pretty. She is really, really popular on Instagram, and everyone that was there, everyone knew her, but somehow I have never heard of her name. And I'm really sad about that. She does these amazing DIY videos out of like old clothes and stuff, which automatically shows you how talented she is. Absolutely love her. I think she is also a very, very strong-willed woman. So I'm guessing all of these contestants have been like acting here and there. So I personally think this is like a huge acting audition, and like Karan Johar is the judge and everyone is auditioning. That is what it looks like because everyone is an actor or they want to be one. The next contestant is Akshara Singh. She is a Bhojpuri actress. She is also so, so stunning. Literally everyone that has came from the same industry comes with the same energy, like the same image that they want to portray. I think she can be a very strong contestant if she ever actually steps out of that image and into her real self, her true self. Apparently she has done a lot of huge work in the industry and she's like a huge star. Everyone knows her, which is great. She deserves it, I'm sure. The next contestant is Moose Jattana, also known as Muskan Jattana. I actually have seen a lot of videos of her all over the internet, never from her real account. It's always the meme pages, you know, the ones that come up on your explore, and she is so funny. I think she has a really fun personality. Apparently some of her videos went viral. I'm not too sure what videos people have been talking about. If you guys know of any videos that went viral and that are problematic, let me know. Other than that, I think she's really cute. She has some great comebacks, and she's very naturally funny, which makes everything look a little more entertaining. So I think she will be like a great addition to the house because everyone else is pretty damn boring and they're very vanilla. The next contestant is Nishant Bhatt. I have seen him on a lot of reality TV dance shows. He is a great dancer. He has a great personality. Nishant actually looks like a very, very smart guy. Usko definitely sabse bahut achhi tarah baat karna aata hai. He knows what to say, when and to whom, which I'm sure will take him very, very far in the game because that is very, very important. But I personally think it's very important to have a character like that in the show. The next and the last contestant that I saved for the last because definitely not my favorite, but I wanted to talk about him a lot. It is Prateek Sehajpal. All right, let's just read his introduction first. Delhi boy Prateek Of course he had to be from Delhi. Of course. I mean, sir. Please calm down. So weird. He's just weird in general. He has to pick up a fight with everyone. I am kidding you not. If you guys have seen the episode, then you would know that he picks up a fight with all the boys. And then I thought he would stop because of course it's the girls and have to stay together and stuff. But then the girls start entering and he picks up a fight with everyone. Every single person. Even Karan Johar was pissed with him. I mean, I'm sure he knows that is what gets TRP in these kind of shows. I don't know how other people cannot see it because everyone else, jab bhi wo lad raha hota hai, wo log sab usko aisa manane ka try karte hai, but how is no one else seeing that this is all pre-planned, he has thought about it all. He has it all planned out in his head. This is what he wants to do. This is what he is trying to do to get further in the show, so that he is constantly in the attention, which he is doing successfully. So I just think he is actually very smart, and the other people that are around him are actually really, really stupid. Other than that, I think he's also really entertaining, because he picks up the stupidest fights. But I'm pretty sure by the end of the show, he will come out looking like a hero, because that is what reality shows do. Anyway, if you guys have seen the first episode, let me know who you guys support, and also let me know what you guys think of all the contestants, and if you guys know of any juicy gossips, secrets, things that they have done pre-show, let me know everything in the comments down below. And that's about it for this video, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. Like, share, subscribe if you guys did. I love you guys for all the constant love and support that you guys have always given me. I love you guys right back. I'll see you guys the next time.